Dairy farming is a business, and like all businesses, its goal is to make profits. But at what cost to the well-being of the animals that the milk is taken from? The stark reality is that this business has victimized cattle to the extent that there might be as much cruelty in a glass of milk as there is in a kilogram of meat. Commercialization of milk has caused cattle to be treated like objects. Cattle are treated like milk-producing machines and not as living beings who, just like humans, desire to live a life free from oppression and exploitation. Dairy cattle are tormented and subjected to physical and emotional torture at every stage of their life. All the information shared in this video are standard practices in the Indian dairy industry. When a calf is born, it is separated from the mother within half an hour. This separation causes extreme emotional distress for both the calf and the cow, which for many days can be heard bellowing loudly in despair, longing for her baby. They are separated so that the milk produced by the mother can be entirely sold for human consumption. An alternate practice on dairy farms is allowing the calf to suckle her mother briefly, twice a day, for a few moments. This helps to coax the mother to start releasing her milk, after which the calf is pulled aside and her milk is collected for human consumption. For the rest of the time, the calf is kept separate from the mother so as to prevent them from drinking the milk which is rightfully theirs. The baby is fed with milk powder or milk in a bucket separately only for a couple of months in decreasing amounts. It is prematurely made to practice eating solid food as young as 10 days of age. In her natural state, it will drink the milk of the mother for 9 to 12 months before it is weaned. The male calves do not produce milk, and their role in agriculture as draught animals is being increasingly substituted by tractors and modern farm equipment. Since the farmer does not want to spend money to feed and take care of an economically unproductive male, it is either abandoned, starved to death, or sold for slaughter. Even in case of dairy farmers who practice agriculture and use bullock, there is a limit to how many bullocks they need to plow their land. Anything more than the required number are additional mouths to feed without being able to derive adequate benefit from them. The gender imbalance statistics speak for itself with regards to the fate of the male calves. In buffalo, which produce 55% of all milk in India, only 15% of them are male and 85% are female. In cows, 35% of them are male and the majority, 65%, are female. When a cow or female buffalo comes of age, it is made pregnant so that it can subsequently produce milk after its calf is born. The majority of the breeding takes place today by means of artificial insemination. This cruel method involves forcibly impregnating a cow by unnatural means. The cow is first restrained, and then a human shoves his bare hands into the anal opening of the cow, and with the other hand he penetrates the vagina with the rod carrying the bull semen to be deposited deep down all the way into the uterus. As per the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare data, artificial insemination was given to 704 lakh animals out of 1,305 lakh breedable population in 2015-16. Artificial insemination is rape just because it is done to a non-human animal who can't fight back and has no legal protection in this matter. It has not become less of a barbaric act. Within 2 months of giving birth, a cow is attempted to be made pregnant again so that it can give birth to a calf 9 months later. Through this practice, the female cattle can be kept in a state of near constant lactation so as to keep the milk flowing in large amounts always. Investigations have revealed the rampant illegal and indiscriminate use of oxytocin in Indian dairy farms. Oxytocin is a hormone that is injected in cows with the hope of increasing milk production. When injected with the hormone, the cow experiences severe stomach cramps similar to labor pains. This comes as no surprise since oxytocin is clinically administered to induce a woman to start labor if she cannot start naturally, or it is given to make contractions stronger if a woman's labor is slowing. Milking of dairy cattle by milking machines can be a painful experience for them. Their teats become red and swollen, and over time, their delicate little teat canals become severely damaged, which results in an infection known as mastitis. In many instances, due to the carelessness of workers, the milk machines keep running even after the cow's udders are empty, resulting in a lot of pain for the cow. Dehorning and disbudding are two brutal mutilations that the cattle are subjected to. Dehorning is the removal of a cattle's horns by physically cutting them off using wires, guillotine shears, dehorning knives or saws. Disbudding involves destroying the cells which produce horns. It is done by shearing the horn buds using a hot iron, which is extremely painful and can damage underlying bone. The cattle experience extreme pain during and after these procedures, and no anesthesia is given, even by the vets. Nose roping involves piercing an animal's nasal septum in front of the cartilage using an iron rod, passing the rope through the hole and permanently fastening the rope behind its head. Pulling or twisting the rope exerts pressure on the extremely sensitive septum, causing the animal pain but makes it easier for the handlers to move them about. In addition to the initial pain of piercing, nose ropes can cause cattle chronic pain and injuries. According to a recent study, moderate to severe injuries in the nostrils were noticed in 62% of the cattle, 3% lesions bled continuously, and 44% had pus discharge. The natural lifespan of cattle is around 20 to 25 years, but due to their inhumane treatment in the dairy industry, this is cut short to 4 to 7 years. The cows stop producing sufficient milk and become unhealthy or suffer severe injuries by the time they attain 4 to 7 years of age. Since the farmer does not want to feed or provide veterinary treatment to an unproductive animal, it is left to die, abandoned, or sold for slaughter. When sold for slaughter, cattle are jammed into overcrowded trucks and transported under inhumane conditions without even being given food or water, in a journey that can last many days to states where they can legally be killed. The dairy industry is the beef industry. All cows and female buffaloes that end up getting slaughtered were once dairy animals who were ill-treated their whole life, after which they are sold to be mercilessly killed at the hands of a butcher. Do these atrocities on cattle happen only on large dairies? No. Even for farmers with up to 5 cattle, their ill treatment is widespread throughout India. On an average, it costs around ₹50 to 100 per day, or sometimes more, to feed and take care of an individual cattle, depending on various factors. To cover costs and make profits, it is standard practice on dairy farms of all sizes to subject them to cruelty for economic gain. In many instances, the handlers also resort to needless beating, mutilation, and abuse just because they can dominate an animal who can't fight back. According to a nationwide survey conducted by India's food regulator, FSSAI, 2 out of 3 Indians drink milk laced with detergent, caustic soda, urea, and paint, among other adulterants. Over 68% of the milk sold did not conform to standards laid down by the FSSAI. The study had analyzed 1,791 samples of milk randomly collected from 33 states and union territories to identify adulterants in milk, both loose and packaged. Apart from adulterants, milk has been found to contain pesticide residues, artificial growth hormones, antibiotics, heavy metals like cadmium, etc., as all the toxic substances that enters the cow's body as either food or medicine makes its way into the milk and are consumed by unsuspecting humans with the false notion that the milk they are drinking is supposed to be healthy. Studies have linked the consumption of milk and milk products to numerous diseases. Among them are higher chances of getting heart disease and diabetes due to the presence of cholesterol and unhealthy fats. Also, a higher likelihood of osteoporosis from the calcium leaching effect from the body milk has due to excessive protein. The two main concerns people have in giving up milk is protein and calcium. The maximum protein required to be healthy, according to the World Health Organization, is only around 8% of our calories from protein. Even this includes a large safety margin. As long as we eat two or more meals a day, it is impossible to not get enough protein, as all fruits, vegetables and grains have protein in them. Calcium is found abundantly in a variety of plant foods. Just as with protein, as long as you eat a balanced diet, you will meet the required daily calcium intake. Humans are the only species in all of nature who drink the milk of another species. That too, after they are no longer babies. Just as with meat, when you buy the flesh of the animals, you are a party to killing of that animal. Similarly, if you consume milk and milk products, you too are responsible for the inhumane treatment they are subjected to, irrespective of whether you approve of such cruelty or not. Will you continue to be a part of this inhumanity, or will you make the change? Go cruelty free, be vegan.